In this tutorial, I'll guide you on creating a walk cycle in After Effects using Dewey Kangela and exporting a vector.json file of the animation to your website using Lottie Files plugin. The download link of both of these plugins is in the description. If you face any difficulty understanding my accent, then turn on the closed caption. Web animation is quite different from video animation, especially when it comes to JSON-based animation for the web. It has its own limitations, and you need to be mindful of every keyframe and shape that you add. Hi, I'm Gaurav, a motion and content designer. I have helped many businesses stand out online using content, animation, and brand design. This tutorial is divided into four parts. One, designing a minimal character using shape layers. Two, rigging the character using Dewey Kangela bones. Three, animating the character using walk, run, cycle automation. Four, preparing the animation for JSON export. To create a minimal figure, I use strokes as much as possible. They simplify rigging and animation and keep the JSON file light. This figure is entirely made of strokes with no closed paths. The character consists of various layers. Hand, composed of four strokes for fingers and thumb. Right arm, made up of two shapes, the arm shape at the bottom and sleeve on the top. Connect the path of the sleeve to the path of the arm using expression pick whip. This will be useful later on when we rig the character. Use trim path property to adjust the size of the sleeve and arm. Head, composed of three strokes, collar, hair and head. Right leg, created similarly to right arm. Both the pant and shoe paths are mapped to the leg path. Use the trim path property here as well to adjust these shapes' length. Body is a stroke with 3 points. Left leg, hand and arm are the duplicates of right leg, hand and arm. One important thing to keep in mind while creating this character is to draw these paths as per the anatomy. Because the bones that we will create later on will follow the points in the path. For example, the first point would be the thigh. Next would be the calf. Next is foot. And the last ones are toes and the tips. You can download the project file from the link in the description if you do not prefer to create the character yourself. If you find this video helpful, please like and share to help me reach more people. With Dewey Kangela, creating bones for this character is pretty easy and quick. Make a copy of this composition, name it Sketch Bones, select the path of the arm shape, go to Dewey Kangela panel, click on the Bones tab and then click on Hominoid. Click on the gear icon next to the arm option and with these options selected, Control plus click on the arm button. All the paths in the arm layer are now controlled by these bones. As the path of the sleeve shape is mapped to the arm shape, it follows the bones too. Align the hand bone properly and map the hand top layer to this bone. The bone can now control the hand as well. Repeat this process for the leg shape in the leg top layer. Click on Hominoid option. Click on the gear icon next to the leg option. Make sure to select all these options and Control plus click on leg button. For the body, choose the spine option of the hominoid. Make sure for this particular character you choose these options. Control plus click on the spine button. Wait for the bones to appear. Map the head layer to the head bone. And now you can see that the body and the head are mapped to the spine. Repeat the similar process for the leg bottom and arm bottom layers. Once you create all the bones, name them properly and color code them for better visibility and arrangement. Before we create controllers, make proper parenting to make the rig work. Parent both the arms to the torso bone and both the thighs bones to the spine bone. Make a copy of this composition and name it Sketch Rigged. Now select all the bones and in the Links and Constraint tab of Dewey Kangela panel, click on Auto Rig. Once your controllers are created, you can hide and shy the bone layers to tidy up the workspace. I would recommend you to select all the control layers and click on the Add Zero button in the Link and Constraint tab. That would make default position of these controllers to zero. Now you can move the legs and arms anywhere you want and then bring them back to their original position by making coordinates 0, 0 again. Although we can keyframe all these controllers to make a walk cycle, but since we are using Dewey Kangela, we can use a quick shortcut. Click on the Automation and Expressions tab in Dewey panel and there you will find this walk run cycle controller. All we have to do is select all these controllers in your composition and click on this gear icon next to the walk run cycle controller. This will open up a list of controllers of your rig. We just need to make sure if the controllers are mapped in the correct manner. We need to fix this bend direction of the leg controller. To do that, change the side to -100 in the effects control tab. There are a bunch of options in arm and leg controllers, but we won't be going into that in this video as we are using walk cycle automation. Let's bring this foot back to its original position. Once all the controllers are mapped correctly, select all of them and click on this walk run cycle button. There you go. The character is now walking. I know this doesn't look perfect, but Duik Angela provides powerful options to control every aspect of this animation. Let's change a few things. Select this animation cycle layer created by walk cycle automation. Go to the effects control panel and expand the walk run cycle effect. Here is the screenshot of the values of all the walk run cycle effect parameters to change the walking animation from this to this. The hard part is over now. Let's render the JSON file of this animation. Duplicate the animation composition and rename it as Sketch Lottie Ready. In order to make this Lottie Ready or JSON ready, we will have to reduce this composition just to these layers and get rid of everything else. Let's make them yellow for better visibility. To make this composition work in the Lottie File plugin, we need to remove all the expressions and effects from the layers. Let's open the arm top layer and convert these expressions, which are created by Duik Angela Rig, into keyframes. One way to do this is to go to the Automation and Expression tab of Duik panel and click on this Bake Expression button. This uses a smart algorithm to create minimum number of keyframes. That is why it takes more time to create keyframes. Keep in mind to delete all these extra keyframes outside of your work area. They increase the size of the JSON file significantly. To avoid creating these extra keyframes, Control plus Shift plus X to change the comp duration to the work area. Now delete all the effects on this layer. We don't need them. See, it is working perfectly. Similarly, go to the leg shape layer and convert these path expressions to keyframes as well. And delete all these effects on the layer. Do the same for body layer. Here we can use right click keyframe assistant method to convert expressions to keyframes. It is much faster. Do the same for the leg bottom and arm bottom layers. Now let's work on these three layers. They don't have any expressions, but they are mapped to the rig. For example, this hand layer is mapped to the hand bone, which in turn is mapped to the forearm bone, which is mapped to the arm bone. Arm is mapped to the spine, which is mapped further. You get the idea. One way to eliminate all of these layers from the picture is to create another null layer and use expressions to get position and rotation of the hand layer and then map the hand layer to it. Let's name it hand top null. And write this expression in the position property. The expression is in the description. This expression gets the position of the given layer in reference to the composition. See, the null layer perfectly coincides with the hand layer and moves with it without parenting. Now, if you map the hand layer to the null layer, it will break. But if you convert this expression to keyframes and then map it, it will work perfectly. One thing you will notice that it is not rotating. To do that, let's first change the parent of the hand layer back to the hand bone so that it doesn't affect the rotation. And open the rotation property of the null layer. The rotation of the hand is the sum of the rotations of all the parent layers. So let's see how far in the hierarchy we should go to make it work. Use the pick whip to get the rotation property of the hand bone. Now add the rotation of the forearm and arm to that. The null is following the hand pretty closely. I think this should work. Convert this expression to keyframes as well. Now map the hand top layer to the hand top null. And check this out. It works perfectly. Now even if you delete all these front arm bone layers, it still works. See? Create a similar null layer for the head. And use the same expression for the position. Convert it to keyframes. For the rotation of the head, use expression pick whip to map the rotation property of the head to the head bone rotation. Now let's see if it's working or not. I think we are good. Convert rotation expression to the keyframes as well, and now map the head layer to the head null layer. For the hand bottom, repeat the exact same process as the hand top layer. Delete these bone layers for the bottom arm. Now we are almost there. Let us delete any effects on these layers. Now let us preview this in the Lottifile panel. We have a bug-free 87 kilobyte JSON file walk cycle. You don't need any of these controllers or bone layers. We can tidy up the workspace by deleting all of them. And we are done. You can tweak the walk cycle parameters to create any number of animations for this composition and convert them into JSON files using the methods we just learned. If you find this tutorial helpful, make sure to subscribe to the channel and share it with your motion designer friends so that everyone can create these kind of animations for the web. Download the entire project file from the link in the description. It is pretty well organized into different comps for easy understanding. It is free to download, but if you want to pay something, it is always appreciated. Check out the website link where I update all my Lottifiles and motion designs. See you in the next video.